president making another major move to dismantle Obamacare, immediately ending federal subsidies to insurance companies that help lower-income Americans afford health insurance. Getting rid of Obamacare was one of his big promises on the campaign trail.
Together, we're going to deliver real change that once again puts America first. That begins with immediately repealing and replacing the disaster known as Obamacare. You're going to have such great health care at a tiny fraction of the cost, and it's going to be so easy.
Repealing and replacing Obamacare, that's what he promised. I want to bring in now Neera Tanden, who helped write Obamacare, CNN's senior economics analyst, Stephen Moore, the former senior economic advisor to the Trump campaign. Hello to both of you. So here we go now. So getting rid of some of the subsidies. Stephen, that was a campaign trail. That was just last year. The president just tweeting this, indicating it may not be that easy so far. Of course, he's saying it's not that easy to repeal and replace. He hasn't had any success with that. But he says Obamacare is causing such grief and tragedy for so many. It is being dismantled. But in the meantime, premiums and deductibles are way up. How will ending subsidies help, Stephen?
Well, let's start, by the way, with this something you were just talking about earlier. Maybe I'm old-fashioned, but I think there's something really refreshing about a politician who actually keeps his promises. And you're right, this was, you know, I campaigned with Donald Trump. This was one of his single most important promises. And I'd even make the case that he had a mandate from the voters to get rid of Obamacare. So obviously Congress struck out on this, and now he's trying to do as much as he can independently of Congress to roll back Obamacare. It's in a state of financial collapse. That's the reason it needs this multi-billion-dollar bailout.
And when Steve, you know that's not true. You guys keep repeating that. It's not true. Well, the facts don't bear that out.
What isn't true?
That Obamacare is collapsing. It's not.
It sure is. I mean, well, let me put it like this, Don. When you have
it's not collapsing under its own weight. It may be collapsing because the president is forcing it to. Republicans are forcing it to collapse.
Hold on, Don.
But not under its own weight. Go read the fact check, but go on.
Okay, well let's do that because this law is 7 years old. It's not as if it started to collapse under Donald Trump. As you know, it started to collapse 4 or 5 years ago when people started paying, you know, premiums that were as much as double as what they used to pay. I mean, I run into people all the time.
So
they can't afford it.
The question was, I want to stick with the question.
Okay.
So how does that help? How does
subsidies? What Donald Trump did yesterday, which was something really significant, which is allow people to essentially opt out of Obamacare and buy much cheaper policies. So Americans are going to save thousands of dollars from that provision, allowing people to buy policies that fit their needs and that they can afford, because people can't afford the $3,000 and $4,000 extra cost of Obamacare. People can now join associated health plans that will be a lot cheaper for people. And then what Donald Trump did today is basically said, look, we're not going to bail out Obamacare exchanges and insurance companies. What's going to happen now is that the Democrats are going to have to come to the table and negotiate with something. I think Trump will fund these if Democrats will allow, for example, more choice for people, more competition, allowing people to buy insurance across state lines.
So yeah. Go ahead, Neera.
I'm so glad you started this by focusing on Donald Trump's promises last year. And things he's done over the last 2 days violate every single promise he made. First of all, he said repeal and replace. There's no replacement. He said he would lower premiums for people, lower health care costs. Today, President Donald Trump took action to increase premiums by 20% in 2018, 25% by 2020. Not lower premiums, increase premiums. He said everyone would stay covered. 1 million people will lose health care, according to the Congressional Budget Office. And finally, he said he'd protect pre-existing conditions. And the policies that Stephen Moore lauds completely undermine pre-existing conditions. So you can get cancer, and one of these junk plans, associated health plans, junk plans, can drop you. That's what makes it cheaper. They don't have to cover pre-existing conditions. That is what makes it cheaper for that part. But if you're concerned about cost, then why have a policy that basically says we're going to increase premiums by 20%? What happened here is that the president betrayed the voters. He said that he was going to help. He made all these promises. And out of spite, for the Affordable Care Act, He is victimizing people who have health insurance through the Affordable Care Act.
But, Neera, he did say he was going to repeal and replace. This isn't a repeal or replace. This is just sort of a dismantling. But,
he did say he was going to repeal and replace. And I say, sure, okay, try doing that. You can't get it through the Congress. No. So you're instead just destroying and destabilizing the health insurance markets.
Well, it is.
That's not
look,
what he promised to do.
Let Stephen respond.
Okay, so first of all, are you really saying that Donald Trump is the one who's breaking his promises? I mean, name one promise of Obamacare. No, literally, go back to the things that Barack Obama said 7 years ago. Every single promise
we
was said violated. You said, you said that if you like the insurance you got, you'll be able to keep it.
Millions of
people are losing their insurance. You said that it wouldn't add to the deficit. Now you need $10 to $15 billion more to bail out the insurance companies.
Okay,
That
was inaccurate. In fact, the Obamacare, the Affordable Care Act reduced the deficit. It has actually saved money. The proposal the president made today by executive action, the way, that's another promise. He wouldn't do executive actions. The thing he did today, the proposal added to the deficit by $200 billion. So if you're concerned about deficit reduction, you should support the Affordable Care Act, which actually reduced the deficit, not what the president did by executive action today.
How is the Affordable Care Act reducing costs for anyone? I mean, look across the country, Neera.
Medical expenditures have actually come down, Stephen.
Hold on, Neera. Yeah.
Wait a minute. I am sorry that the president lied occasion after occasion, Neera. Wait a minute. One at a time, please.
Okay, come on. I mean, let's be honest here. Americans are facing 25, 30, 40, 50. I just got back from Arizona. Explain to me, if insurance costs are coming down, why people in Arizona are paying double what they used to pay for insurance.
Let me just say, I think you've dealt with propaganda from the last couple of years and not with the facts. First of all, there's not a single bear market in the country. Insurers are everywhere. Premiums have been going up. And you know why insurance companies say the premiums are going up? Not me, not my friends. Insurance companies say premiums are going up because the president is threatening the subsidies.
Neera, stop.
That's exactly what's happened.
The insurance
fund.
Wait a minute. There's a problem with this. Neera, wait a minute. Wait, hold on. If that's the case, explain to me why the insurance premiums went up a year and a half before Donald Trump even announced he was running for president.
And before. Just to
they were going up before Stephen Donald Trump announced he was running for president.
Do you understand how the Affordable Care Act works? I'd just like to say. When a premium goes up, there's a subsidy increase. When the premium goes up, there's a subsidy increase. 90% of the premium increase have been effectively not felt by consumers. What the president did today was say, I'm going to take away the subsidies. Right. So when your premiums go up, you pay for it, not anyone else. That's what's destructive. If you're so concerned about premium increases, why would the president take action to increase premiums by 20%? And don't listen to me. Listen to the insurance companies, the doctors, every stakeholder in the insurance company and the health system has said the president did was wrong.
Love Obamacare because it gave them a big market.
Okay,
but I got to tell you, I talked to people around the country. They said their insurance premiums are going up 20 or 30%. Millions
of
Americans.
Because of what the president is doing.
I've got to go. Thank you. Always a pleasure. You guys don't need me. I'm just going to over a glass of wine or something to chill you guys out a little bit and get something done. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. When we come back.